John, what are you doing here?
To the powers that be at Johns Hopkins, I realize you are a pain in the neck and don't want to pay you that big buck anymore.
Amazingly enough, they like me at Johns Hopkins as well. They put up with me anyway, but I'm pretty damn good at what I do, the same way you used to.
Listen, I don't understand. You guys can pick up a 40-year-old argument as if no time had ever passed. How do you do that?
It's a gift.
Well, you know, I've had some practice with another physician lately.
Oh, how can I forget?
Yes, a brilliant neurosurgeon on staff who has some personality issues.
Would this be Dr. Reid Oliver?
You know him?
I only know him over the phone, but he's the fellow who got me to come back here.
What for?
For a cardiac consult.
Really? Well, who's the patient?
Dr. Dixon, I'm so glad to meet you.
Dr. Oliver, I believe that you've overlooked something.
Are you Dr. Oliver?
Oh, yeah, right. I was going to say that. I've been working on, you know, being more polite.
On your manners, yes. Well, they're overrated. Besides, they take so much effort. You know?
I'm on the same page with you there.
They could be the same person.
Dr. Oliver?
Wait, what did I overlook?
Explain to me why you asked Dr. Dixon to come here.
Oh, that. Yeah. Well, I was going to explain that. Tomorrow. It can wait. Our patient can't. Is this your bag?
Yes, it is.
All right. Well, I'm sure that Dr. Dixon's in a hurry to get to the hospital.
You know, since I just checked in, I thought I might go upstairs and just
okay,
check
well,
it
we
off.
Can bring the bag with us to the hospital. I'll brief you on the way.
Excuse me. Don't you think you at least give John a chance to get his breath?
I appreciate your sense of urgency, but I have some socks I gotta
okay,
get.
Okay, well, you know, I'll walk you up to the room, and then...
Why don't I walk John to the room? You stay here and brief Bob on this emergency patient, and John and I'll have a few minutes to catch up on Andy.
Andy,
our son. Mrs. Hughes and I were married at one time.
Whatever you're thinking, don't say it.
Don't worry, Doctor. Kim and I won't be long.
Look, I'm going to check in with the hospital while I'm waiting. But, you know, I'll catch up with you tomorrow around noon. Does that sound good? Okay, good. Well, I'll see you later.
No, you'll see me right now. Explain.
What exactly?
Well, you bring Dr. Dixon in here for a consult. Former member of the staff. He and I have a long history, and you don't tell me about it.
Sorry. Anything else?
Yeah, there's a lot more. I'd like to know why you did that. Okay, Doctor. Why is Dr. Dixon here?
For a consult.
I know that. But who's the patient?
Oh, like I bother to learn these people's names. Since when do you question the way I treat a patient? Dixon's reputation is stellar. I mean, we could, you know, send him back while you decide whether or not it's a good idea. I don't want to break any procedural rules since there's nothing really at stake. Oh, yeah, except somebody's life.
I think you're going to like this guy.
Uh-huh. I want a full briefing on this later.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Well, obviously, you have learned how to manage Dr. Bob.
It's hit or miss. Listen, I'm really glad that you could help on this one, Dr. Dixon.
Why didn't you tell him I was coming?
It's a need-to-know basis.
The chief of staff doesn't need to know? Come on. Who is this mystery patient, anyway?
You'll find out soon enough.
Right, Mom. Right. Okay, I'll see you later. Bye-bye. She wants to hear all the details about Barbara and Henry's wedding.
Yeah, sure. Listen, honey, you know that John always has some kind of a trick up his sleeve somehow. And now Reid brings him here for some mysterious patient and doesn't run it past you first?
Yeah, that was presumptuous.
I'll say. And who is this patient, I mean, who's so urgent and you don't know anything about him?
It's puzzling.
I just have a feeling there's something odd going on. Honest, I just don't want it to end up hurting you and Chris.
But I think I'll swing by the hospital and just try to find out what's going on.
Good.
It isn't the same around here without you.
Oh, you mean not enough drama, less intrigue, not enough tantrums, no tantrums?
Hey, there's nobody manning the desk. Are you resting? Am I the only one working today?
No shortage of tantrums.
Nice to see you again, Greta.
Let me know if you need anything.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, I'm kind of in a hurry.
Okay, let's go to work. Why don't you give me the chart for Mr. What was his name again, this patient?
I never said. It's all been handled kind of informally and off the record.
Yeah, why is that?
Here's a list of the medications that he's taken already. He's also been on intermittent oxygen.
Is this your idea of a medical history? What kind of silly game are you playing here, Dr. Oliver?
He was never formally admitted to the hospital. This is the best that I could do.
Where's his MRI?
There hasn't been one.
Why not?
The patient was resistant, so I never ordered one.
You know, I hope I didn't make a mistake by consenting to come here. Who ordered these meds?
I did.
But you're a neurosurgeon.
And wishing I had my hands deep in somebody's brain right about now.
What is a neurosurgeon doing treating a patient with myocarditis, even though it is informally? Chris! Christopher Hughes!
Mr. Dixon, how are you?
Well, I'm just fine, fine, thank you. I'm surprised to see you. I didn't know you were back from your travels.
I'm pleased that you're back from your travels as well. Now you can explain this mess.
He's an odd duck, isn't he?
No argument from me on that one.
Look at you. By golly, you're all grown up here, and you're in the family business.
Yeah, yeah. Good to see you. Thanks.
Yes. So what do you know about this mystery cardiac case?
Reid told you?
He just told me I'm here to treat some poor fellow with myocarditis.
You're the cardiologist?
Yes. Why?
I'm the poor fellow.
Well, give Valisa my apologies.
Oh, of course not. Oh,
good God almighty, am I having a nightmare? Or did I just see that Johnny Boy Dixon check into my hotel?
Now sit down, lie down, and take this. You should have taken you into radiology on a gurney, too.
Look, my father doesn't know anything about this. If people see me riding around on a gurney, then he's going to know.
And you don't think that the radiologist is going to mention anything to somebody here at the hospital about any of this stuff?
Look,
put that back on and let me do the talking. Your concern for your mother and father are admirable, okay? But you're endangering your own life. I mean, what did you think would happen?
I would recover on my own.
On your own. That's good. You know, if you had gone to see somebody as soon as you arrived from Africa, if you had come to see me then, perhaps you wouldn't be in the lousy shape you're in right now.
John, hi. I'm so glad you're here.
Hey, what are you doing here?
She and Chris have a thing.
Hey.
Don't touch the damn oxygen.
Yes, sir. Where's Jacob?
He's with a neighbor. He's fine. How is he?
Dr. Dixon, here are the MRI results.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, it's not what I hoped it would be.
Pepper.nl en vind ook jouw perfecte match. Pepper. Love to date.
Inflammation caused by the virus has been there for quite some time.
What does that mean?
That means that the muscles in Chris's heart have been severely damaged.
Well, what can be done to repair them?
Well, it's difficult, but it is possible.
I think Katie needs to hear the options for treatment.
There are several. We'll start with the most conservative and see what that gets us.
And when will you start?
Right away.
As soon as they tell their family what's going on.
I'm on that.
Good. I'll go with you if you want.
Yeah, be good. Be good. Maybe the best thing to do is get everybody together and tell them all at once.
Honey, you've made your peace with John a long time ago.
Well, I know that, but you know that whenever John Dixon walks in the door, there's trouble right behind. Well, who better than you should know?
You're right.
And you're right.
This used to be a quiet town, and now John is back. Oh, it's Chris. Hello, son.
Hey, Dad, is Mom with you?
Yeah, she is. We're with Lisa. You want to talk to her?
I thought you and Mom could meet Katie and me over at, Tom and Margo's house.
When?
half hour. And could you bring Lisa and Graham with you, too? Because this is something that the whole family needs to hear.
Oh, sure. I'll see you soon.
Bob, you seem confused.
Well, Chris and Katie want to see us.
You and me?
And Lisa and Mom. And I guess Tom and Margot are involved because it's at their house. I wonder what this is.
Oh, what else could it be?
I don't know.
What?
Oh, honey, just think. What kind of an announcement would Chris want to make in front of the whole family with Katie? They're going to get engaged.
You think Katie's ready to get married this soon after Brad's death?
Well, I suppose you've got a point. It's just a little less than a year.
Never know. Why not? I mean, Chris is such a cute cat.
Listen, before you two have them marching down the aisle, I'll go get Mom. I guess hospital is out.
Oh, you know something? Barbara's bouquet must really be lucky for Katie. So, therefore, I'm going to start catching a few of those bouquets myself.
You go, girl.
Thank you.